You might have seen this beauty in my previous shorts where I am showing you this beauty and saying that I am going to make a video about its care. So here I am with a video. Hey guys! For those who are new here, my name is Sheetal and I make plant related and health related content on my channel. Welcome to my channel. So as I promised you friends, I am here with the video about pothos care in which I am going to talk about how I managed to grow them this big, this bushy and this tall, these long vines. I am going to talk about everything. Most importantly, I am going to tell you the secret how to make them this bushy. So without any further delay, let's get started. Pothos, which has many names like Scindapsis, Epipremnum, Devil's Ivy, Money Plant. There are so many names for this plant and there are n number of ways to style this plant as well. You can style them in hanging basket. You can grow them on moss stick where you can give it a look of big tree. You can plant 2-3 vines in a pot and keep it on the shelf, any bookshelf or any shelf, and let the vines trail down. That looks pretty. Then you can keep it on the floor and let the vines grow up on the wall and let them grow till the roof. Then you can make green wall with pothos. There are many different ways to style the plant. And it's very common house plant. You get to see this plant in many households. It's really common everywhere. And most common variety is golden pothos. I have 5 different varieties of pothos. One is this neon pothos. Other one is Scindapsis, which is silver satin pothos. Then enjoy pothos. Then I have planted 2 vines of golden pothos also in it. One is trailing on my window, golden pothos only. And there is one more plant where I have planted golden pothos and they are climbing on a moss stick. And if you have watched my previous video where I am propagating many plants, in that video I had shown you I got a few cuttings of pothos from Goa. That is the elephant's ear pothos variety, which grow really big. Their leaves are real big, like Monstera Deliciosa leaves. They grow that big and at certain point they start fenestration also. So I'm just hoping they will grow big on that curry leaves tree. Now let's start the main thing, how I take care of my pothos, how I manage to grow them this bushy. And most importantly, I am going to tell you the secret how I made this planter look so bushy. If you remember, I had shown you this planter, this particular plant in my one of my video where I am showing top 10 favorite plants or maybe plants which you can gift. I don't remember exact which video I had showed you this plant, and you might remember in that video how bald this plant looks. Here top of the pot, top of the planter, it looks really bald in that video. If you remember, if you go and check, you will get to see how bald it was and now how bushy it looks. So I'm going to share all those secrets with you guys, so don't go anywhere, watch my video till the end. And without any further delay, let's get started. First thing, most important thing, what kind of soil you should provide, you should plant your pothos into. So pothos are moisture loving plants and at the same time they don't like to sit in water and they don't like to sit in soggy soil. So your soil mix should be moisture retaining, but at the same time it should be well drained soil. You should take mixture of garden soil, then cocoa peat for moisture retention, and perlite or sand or pumice. You can use any one of these 3, perlite, sand or pumice, for good drainage, to provide good drainage to your soil. While you make soil mixture for your pothos, you should add good amount of compost to your soil. so that for next another 6 months you don't have to fertilize your pothos, and after 6 months you can start fertilizing it like once in 15 days or once in 3 weeks you can fertilize your pothos. I'm going to talk about what kind of fertilizers you can use for your pothos. Now let's talk about what kind of light it needs, where you are supposed to place your pothos. Pothos love bright indirect light, and if you are keeping them outdoor, then don't keep them in direct sunlight. They don't like harsh direct sunlight. Their leaves will start burning, they will start browning. So if you are keeping them outdoors, keep them in shaded place where they will receive enough amount of bright indirect light, but no any direct light. And even though pothos love bright indirect light, they do well in low light also. This is one of the low light loving plant, not loving actually, low light tolerant plant. It can tolerate low light. It do better in low light as well. It will survive in low light, but it won't thrive as much as it thrives in bright indirect light. If you don't get good light at your home, you don't have bright lit room in your home, but you want to add few plants in your house, then you can go for pothos. They will survive in low light also. That was about the light condition it needs. Let's talk about how to water them. My thumb rule for watering pothos is I check their leaves. If their leaves look droopy, you know, pothos, they talk to me, they tell me when they need water, and with the help of their leaves they will tell me their leaves will start looking droopy, and that's the sign that means this plant is thirsty and it needs water. Even if you see this Scindapsus pictus soil, it looks completely dry. It is pretty dry, almost dry, but still look at its leaves. They are so beautiful and they are looking fresh and strong right now. So that means it doesn't need water. When this plant is thirsty, its leaves will start curling inwards. That is the sign that this one needs water, and that's the signal for me. My baby is thirsty and I have to water it. And that time I water it thoroughly. I water it properly until the water drains out from the drainage holes. You should not overwater this plant. If you start overwatering it, it will start dropping its leaves and it will go completely bald. Roots will start rotting and your plant will die. You should not overwater this plant, but at the same time you should not water it irregularly. Irregularly means, suppose, as I said, you started overwatering this plant, you got a sign from the plant that it started yellowing its leaves or it started dropping its leaves, and you understood you are overwatering it. Then what you did, you completely stopped watering it. You know, earlier you were overwatering, you're overfeeding your plant, and after some time, once you understood, you completely stopped watering it and it has become completely dry, then that is a great shock, great stress for your plant, and at that point your plant will stop growing. So don't water irregularly. And another sign your plant will show if you are watering it irregularly, that is its leaves tips will start turning brown. If you see browning tips at your pothos leaves, that means you are watering your plant irregularly. Or another cause for browning tips is it's not getting enough humidity. That leads me to the next point, humidity. What kind of humidity it needs? It loves humidity. It's a humidity loving plant, so a humidity level should be higher. And if you don't have high humidity at your place, then what you can do, you can go for humidifier, or else you can start misting your leaves. But misting won't give your plants longer time humidity, because water will stay on the leaves for some time. Water will stay on the leaves for some time, and once the water gets dried out, then the humidity level is going to go down again. So best option is to keep a humidifier next to your plants. You can collect all the humidity loving plants and you can keep a humidifier. And if you don't want to go for humidifier, then at least do one thing, keep a group all the humidity loving plants together, and they will share each other's immunity and they will thrive over there. So that was about humidity. Next, problems with the plant. As I said, yellowing leaves, which is sign of overwatering, then browning tips, which is the sign of irregular watering or humidity, lesser humidity. Then next problem is pests. I have seen millibugs all the time on my pothos. Even this one still has millibugs. I keep on cleaning them, I keep on spraying this plant. Most of the times I do that, but still those dirty creatures, they come back on my plant. But I am cleaning them regularly, I am, you know, spraying neem oil and everything regularly. That's why they are not harming my plants. They haven't harmed my plant yet, and it's not affected its growth. But still, millibugs is the major pest problem I have faced with my pothos. So what kind of fertilizer you should use? Pothos love nitrogen rich fertilizer, so you should go for cow dung compost. That is the best fertilizer to use for pothos. Then you can go for seaweed extract also. And if you are growing on moss stick, then what you can do, you can spray the solution, seaweed extract solution or any liquid fertilizer on moss stick as well. And while watering also, you should wet the moss stick, because what happens, these tiny roots pothos has over here at their nodes, it has roots, tiny aerial roots, and they can get nutrients and water from the moss stick. So if you compare the leaves in trailing or hanging pothos are smaller compared to the leaves size on moss stick, because on moss stick they get proper nutrients from their aerial roots also. Over here they don't receive any nutrients from their aerial roots. Then I'm going to tell you about one more fertilizer which is very easily available in our kitchens, which is this tea powder. You don't have to use fresh tea powder. You can use tea powder which you are going to throw after making tea out of it. What you will do, you will just clean the tea powder after draining out tea from it. You just wash it properly. If you are putting any other things like ginger or lemongrass into your tea, remove those things and let the tea powder dry properly. And after that, you just have to sprinkle that tea powder. I'm just using fresh tea powder only. Sprinkle that in the soil of your plant. And before fertilizing, what you are supposed to do, you should loosen up the soil little bit and then put fertilizer, then cover it with the soil, and after that water it. It's compulsory, you should water your plant after fertilizing it. Then only all the nutrients from the fertilizer are going to dissolve in water and then into soil, and that going to reach to your plant. So always remember, you always water your plants while fertilizing. Once you add fertilizer to the soil, you have to water the plant. So that was about fertilization. Then let's move on to propagation. There are many different ways to propagate pothos, and this is very easy plant to propagate. It's pretty easy to propagate. If you see this vine, these all are the nodes of your plant. If you cut it over here and put this directly into soil, it's going to grow in another beautiful vine. Or else what you can do, you can cut these nodes and put them in water for rooting. Let them root in water properly, and after that you can transfer them into soil. You can go for this method also. This is the efficient method I have ever came across. You just have to take a container filled with soil. Actually, if you see in this pot, I have already planted a few vines, because I did it on camera, but by mistake I lost the footage, so I am going to show it again. So you just have to take a container filled with soil and take a vine from mama plant and fix it to the soil with the help of U-pin, or any kind of clip which will help your vine to fix into the soil, and just let it grow over there. In this case, what will happen? The vine is still attached to the mama plant. You don't have to cut the vine from mama plant. Keep it attached to the mama plant, and as it is attached to mama plant, it's going to get food from mama plant, and as well as it will start rooting over there, and it will, once it roots, it will start growing its own food over there. So this method which I have shown you, I find it very efficient and very reliable method, because in this case failing of propagation chances are very less, they are none actually. This is another most common and popular method of propagating pothos, which is water propagation. Like previous footage, I lost this footage also, so I'm just showing you. I cut the piece of vine from its mama plant and I just removed the last two leaves from its nodes, because I'm going to insert those nodes in water. And ta-da, you're done for water propagation. Your plant is going to start growing roots in water, and it's going to grow into a new plant. If you are rooting them in water, then what happens? Once you transfer your cuttings from water to soil, there is a change in medium, then the growth of the plant slows down. Suppose in water it has already started growing new leaves, once you transfer them into soil, the growth stops for some time. So I prefer propagating them in the way I showed you guys. Now I'm going to share the secret about how to make your plant look like this, so bushy, without any bald spots on them. This is pretty simple to do actually. You just find out bald spots in your pot and just take a crawling vine and try to fix it in the soil, and with the help of U-pin just fix it in the soil. From there your plant will start growing roots into the soil, and it will grow little bit bigger leaves also, and it will help to hide the bald spots as well. You just have to follow the way I'm doing in the video. You just do that and it will cover all the bald spots, and it will grow healthy vines with the help of this. Another way to make your plant look bushy is their trimming. You just have to trim the vines regularly, which will induce new growth, which will start branching of your vines, and it will make your plant look more bushier. So friends, these are the two ways which will help your plant look more and more bushier. If you keep on pruning them regularly, then they are going to induce really good growth and your plant will grow bushier day by day. And for hanging baskets, you can follow the method which I have shown you right now. So guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you find my video useful for you. I hope you liked it. And if you like my video, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you have already done that, then thank you very much. And I'm sharing my Instagram ID on the screen. You can follow me on Instagram as well. If you are watching my video for the first time, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share my videos with your friends and family. In our country, cases are growing rapidly. So you guys stay home, stay safe, stay healthy, and take care of yourself. Don't go in crowded places. Stop attending functions as well for a few days. Nothing is going to happen if you skip a few functions. And stay safe, stay healthy. I take your leave now. Bye. Take care. Bye-bye.